Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you are here. If you are visiting for the first time, thank you so much. If you are returning, thank you as well. Today I'm walking you through how you can design your own custom stickers like these right here using Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at express.adobe.com, and I'll start by clicking on the plus sign here and choose a custom size graphic. Now this is the important piece. You want to start off with a large enough size that has lots of pixels per inch. That way when you print it out, it comes out sharp. So one of the things that you can do is just go with a default right here that is 2560 by 2560, or you can bump it up to 3000 pixels by 3000 pixels. And one thing you could do here, once you do that, you can check the inches and it'll show you that this is a 10 by 10. Now, you're not going to print out a 10 by 10 sticker. Most likely it'll be a half inch by half inch. If it's a circle, a 2-inch circle or square, you will be just fine doing this here. I'm going to go ahead and go back to the pixels here and go and click on next. The canvas size for this sticker here is a square, but I'm going to show you how you can design a circle here. If it's going to be a sticker that is cut out as a circle, you can use a square just fine. So we'll start off here with choosing a shape. So let's go ahead and type in circle. So let me demo the circle here, and I'll go ahead and choose the one option here, more shapes. And let me go ahead and close that out. And I'll go ahead and just size this up all the way close to the edge here on each side. That way it's pretty much centered, and I can go ahead and click and drag just to make sure. You see the little marching ants? Now I know I'm centered. And let me go ahead and go with, let's say that I'm going to choose this greenish color for my sticker. Now, right now I'm designing it as a circle within a square, but when I do send it into the printers, I do want it entirely covered in the same color. So let me go now with adding a text here, and I'm going to add a text and have it show up around the edge of the circle. Now I'm going to go ahead and add my website here, and let's go with I am Claudius. And then I'm going to show you a cool trick here. So right now the text is showing up in a straight format here. Let me close that, and let me go ahead and go with white font or color white for my text. And here I'm going to change to my branded font or something a little more that's along the lines of mine. So let me go ahead and go with this one here. I like that. Oop, let's make sure and add that C for .com. There we go. And I'll just go ahead and size it out. Now I do want this to show up on the edge. I want it to go along the outline of the circle. So what I'm going to do is come over here to the curved grid and magic alignments, and I'm going to choose the curved, the semicircle inverted. As you can see, it automatically does that. And then what I'll do is go ahead and size this up so that it lines up right about there. Maybe bring it in a tad bit. It takes a little bit of tweaking here, but that should be good enough. Now, it is capitalized because I'm using the alignment here. And let's just show you. See, there's the original. But if I choose a different font, just to let you know, if you decide to go with the curved, it is going to automatically make it into all caps. That way you know. Something else that you can do is space it out. So right now it's at 15 letter spacing, but if you want to make that smaller, which sometimes this looks a lot nicer, you can do that. Just show you, I'm going to go the opposite direction. Something like that I think looks great. And then what I'll do now is, I have a logo that I had created years ago. I did it in Illustrator. I designed it and drew it out. So I want to bring it in and drop it in here. So I'm going to go ahead and go to photos and bring it in from my computer. So let's drop it in here. There's my logo here. I used to have a full beard, but just to let you know, that's kind of what it looked like. So I'm going to size that up, center it some here into the circle or the center of the artboard. There we go. Now it is black, but I want this to be in white. So I'm going to show you a cool trick here. It is over here in effects. I'll turn the effects on. If you notice, it automatically went to a duotone, which is a blue. And what I'll do here is choose the current color for both in white. So that way it shows up white. So it's kind of like an inverted logo there. I think it looks pretty cool. If I wanted to go the opposite direction, the cool thing about it is all you need to do is now create a duplicate by clicking on this button here at the bottom. It created an exact copy of the page just to show you. So I can create an alternate version of my sticker. And now I can go back here and uncheck that and then go to the font and let's make the font to black. And then I can change the sticker now, just going to basic white. So now I have a sticker that is with my branded color and I have the opposite with all black and logo and black text. Now, as I mentioned, when you do send this off to the printers, now one of the ones that I like using is Sticker Mule. You check out stickermule.com. They're not paying me to mention them. I just use them for all my sticker needs. They are great. So one thing I would do is this one right here is go ahead and download that one. As that one is ready, I can send it off and you have the options to choose a circle sticker. Now for this one, if I wanted this one to be sent out to any printer, what I would do is in the background is select the full color, the same color as your sticker. That way when you send it in and there is some cutoff, there's some bleeding, that's a term in printing, that way you get the full color. Because if you do send this in, you may get a little bit of white into your sticker. So in case you want it all the same color, just make sure and choose something like that. So this is a circle sticker. If you wanted to send a square sticker, obviously what you would do is instead of having this curve, you can just go back to the straight format and have it somewhere down here. And you make adjustments, add QR codes or any other things for your stickers you can send off. Logos that you may have created, go ahead and add them as well. And then remember to download them. I recommend whenever you're ready to download to choose, let me go ahead and undo this and go back to my curve, is choose download. You can do all pages and choose PNG, the option. That way it's better quality when you send it on in. And I have not had any issues with printing anything that's 2 inches or below when I use the size as I mentioned at the start. And there you go. Now it's your turn to design your own stickers using Adobe Express. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.